the DEA made the decision it did based on its assessment of the risk, and the mayor was right to want clarification from the DEA.
Burlington Police Chief Brandon Del Pozo is standing by his boss, who wants to hear from the Drug Enforcement Administration after it performs a review of Tuesday's deadly shooting of a drug suspect.
One of the factors that needs to be taken into account is are innocent civilians being put unnecessarily at risk.
During the execution of a search warrant at Kenneth Stevens' Elmwood Avenue apartment, police say two bullets fired by either a DEA agent or Vermont State Trooper flew through Stevens' exterior wall, across a driveway, and into a neighboring property.
And I support the mayor's statement. He's right to want answers from the federal government about how this was done. We execute high-risk search warrants ourselves here, and we have our way of doing things, and we try to make decisions that maximize the safety to the public.
City police officers were part of the raid, but the DEA wrote the operational plan for the search warrant, according to Chief Del Pozo. He says because authorities knew Stevens had been arrested for manslaughter and they believed he had a high-powered gun, having 16 officers on the scene made sense. Del Pozo says he's most concerned with what the bullets did.
I think the issue is more about what types of weaponry are used and how much wood and sheetrock those weapons can penetrate, rather than a worry about evacuating every single person in the proximity.
Both the mayor and the police chief say Stevens was a violent felon actively selling heroin and crack cocaine in the city. They say it's unfortunate the fatal shooting happened during the holiday season, but say policing never stops.
The people out in the community victimizing our community are doing it 24/7, 365. And it's our duty to be working to secure the city regardless of whether it's the holidays or not.
In Burlington, Hannah McDonald, WPTZ News Channel 5.